like we've been seeing. I'll have the complete forecast.
We have to keep going.
Word is spreading along the coastline. People working around the clock to help bring home two missing local teens. We're live from Jupiter and Jacksonville with an update on the search. Next on the Fox 29 10 o'clock news.
It's summer.
Ugh.
And at first, I was like,
so bored.
But Teen Choice is almost here, so I was like,
cool.
This year, it's going to be different. Teens get to decide the categories.
Yes.
And I was like, then I heard 5 Seconds of Summer, Little Mix, and the cast of Empire were performing, and I was totally like, yes.
Awesome.
Yay.
This is amazing.
Teen Choice 2015, live Sunday, August 16th on Fox.
Welcome back to the show. Moses and Edson from Team Stage and Asaf and Burim from Team Street are up for elimination. Which two dancers have done enough to persuade the judges to save them? Nigel, I know you've been in deep discussions.
We Over have ever you. Since we heard America's vote. Mm-hmm. We have been discussing it. And obviously we're going to be losing one of our two B-boys tonight.
Yes.
And I'd like to say to both of them, that you bring something very special to this competition. Your athleticism, your strength, your excitement, and your bravery really stands out to us all in your choreography. But this is all about opening up to everything. So both of you, I know, have not reached your true potential yet. However, we have decided tonight to keep Asaf.
On the stage?
On the stage, boys, I can tell you now that we have decided to keep Edson.
Congratulations to Edson and to Asaf. You guys can leave the stage really well done, which means that we are losing Burim and Moses this evening. Let's hear it for them one last time, please, ladies and gentlemen. What fine, fine gentlemen and competitors. Okay, back to you, America. Assign your votes to your favorite dancers and submit them now. You have until 9 a.m. Pacific time tomorrow. Remember, one stage and one street dancer will be leaving us next week. Here's a quick reminder of tonight's performances.
Carly posts,
breaking up with the longest relationship I've ever had. Hashtag sad but true.
Good riddance, Carly.
Hashtag 96 months too long.
Oh, the car. Right. Well, now's a perfect time to head over to the Honda Summer Clearance event. We've got great deals on the Honda Civic, the best-selling car in its class. So ditch that loser.
Hey.
Still talking about the car.
Oh.
Hurry in to the Honda Summer Clearance event for a great deal on your new Honda.
City Furniture has been part of the community for 44 years. During our anniversary sale, a complete queen bedroom is just $9.99. A bonded leather sectional, $9.99. A five-piece dining set, $5.99. And find more anniversary specials at cityfurniture.com. Plus, get same-day delivery and no interest till 2017. Join the celebration at City Furniture.
Your neighborhood forecast is as close as your cell phone. Text weather to 29,000 for up-to-the-minute weather forecasts every day. Weather on the go from Storm Team Fox.
Tonight, a desperate search for two teens lost at sea after this capsized clue.
Yeah, just confirm nobody's on board.
Family holding out hope.
We have no other option but to remain positive.
Friends lighting up the night. And the Coast Guard believing there's a chance they're still alive.
There's only so long you could stay in the water. 4 to 5 days is in these conditions.
Live, local, 1 hour earlier. Fox 29, 10 o'clock news starts now.
There are new calls for help tonight as the Coast Guard expands their search for those teens even farther north.
Crews are focusing on a 27,000 square mile area north of where their boat was spotted in the water.
We have live team coverage of this search at sea. Our crews spanning from Palm Beach County north to Jacksonville tonight. We begin with Fox 29 anchor Jay Cashmere, who is live in Tequesta, where the family is anxiously waiting for any answers. Jay.
John, Ashley, they certainly are. The village of Tequesta and the surrounding town of Jupiter holding out hope tonight for the survival of Perry and Austin. Behind me here, the family has been gathering with friends all evening long to pray and to support each other at this time of need. We've also seen the village of Tequesta police chief. He's been on site here for most of the evening. The family's been waiting for answers for 3 days now. Tonight, the Coast Guard continues its massive and aggressive search off the coast of Jacksonville. They're focusing their efforts all night tonight and tomorrow morning as well along a small pocket of the Florida-Georgia line just north off the coast of Jacksonville, where a big clue popped up yesterday. The boy's 19-foot vessel was found capsized, and due to all the factors of Mother Nature tonight, the currents, the Gulf Stream, they're focusing their efforts right up in that area, and that's where we want to begin tonight with Fox 29's Michelle Quesada. She is standing by live at headquarters there, Coast Guard Station Mayport, with the very latest on the search and rescue effort tonight. Michelle.
This station has joined the search. By midnight tonight, the Coast Guard will have searched 27,000 square miles from east of Jupiter and up north to the coast of Jacksonville. Now, we talked to several Coast Guard members, and they say that they were able to assess and narrow their search after finding the teen's boat, which capsized outside of the Ponce Inlet. And we've talked to several people out here in Jacksonville, people along the coast of Florida, who say that they are learning about Perry and Austin and that they're hoping the Coast Guard crews will bring the boys home soon.
Ann Butcher and Buddy Duncan share the same passion for fishing that Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen do. Now they're learning, along with other Jacksonville locals, that the Coast Guard is searching off the coast for the 14-year-olds missing from Jupiter since Friday.
That's pretty scary. I mean, we're out here all the time, and even the current just along here will pull you out.
Video released today by the Coast Guard shows the 19-foot-long boat the teens took out of the Jupiter Inlet capsized 67 miles east of the Ponce Inlet near Cape Canaveral.
Yeah, just confirm nobody's on board.
Not too far from the boat was a life vest.
We are hopeful that maybe they both have life jackets on.
The Coast Guard says the teens were believed to be on their way to the Bahamas on a fishing trip and were used to taking out their boat. Still, Butcher, who fishes often, says it's a challenging task no matter how much experience you have.
You have to be smart, you have to know your tides, you have to know where you're at, have the right gears.
Coast Guard crews say finding the boat helped crews on five different Coast Guard cutters and aircrafts adjust the search zone. They are hopeful that the teens could survive in warm water for about 4 to 5 days.
People can survive in the water. It's relatively warm, But again, it's a dangerous environment, and there's only so long you could stay in the water.
Crews will be searching all throughout the night and all day tomorrow. The Coast Guard has not said whether it will expand the search beyond Jacksonville, north of Jacksonville. They're taking their search efforts one day at a time. Reporting live from the Coast Guard Station Mayport in Atlantic Beach, Michelle Quesada, Fox 29 News.
Michelle, thank you. Well, this story went from local to national to international almost overnight. And much of that is from the support of the local community here, really coming together to offer a helping hand in any way possible. Fox 29's Alyssa Hyman joining me now here in Tequesta with more on a very special ceremony tonight. Alyssa.
Well, tonight, hundreds gathered at the Jupiter Inlet to light up the night, a small but powerful symbol to show that no one's giving up hope.
God, you're still in charge.
More prayers for Perry and Austin.
Everyone said.
Amen.
As illuminated lanterns floated up above the Jupiter Inlet Monday night.
I know that everyone here still has hope and that God's still in control.
There's still no signs of 14-year-olds Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen, the two Tequesta teens who went missing from a fishing trip sometime Friday.
It was devastating when I found out. Like, I didn't believe it. I was like, no, they're on the boat all the time. Like, how could this have happened?
And tonight, from the very spot the boys left, an entire community united together to light up the night.
Hopefully, like the lanterns will fly far enough that they'll be able to see them and just know that we're still looking for them.
A small but powerful display in the sky that there's still hope for the boys' safe return home.
Just in case the boys are out there and they see that light, they know we're waiting for them to come home and that no one's forgot about them.
Now, this was an event organized just hours before it all came together, and that's just a testament to all the support these two boys have in this community. We're reporting live in Tequesta. Alyssa Hyman, Fox 29 News. Jay, back to you.
Alyssa, thank you very much. Well, two people who have remained vigilant, wrapped in hope that their boys will be found safe and sound, are the mothers of Perry and Austin. They will not let go of an image in their mind that both of their sons will return home to this very community where they grew up. The bond between Carly Black and Pamela Cohen can't get any stronger.
No one understands what I'm going through but Pamela, and vice versa, and we have to stick together.
For 3 days and counting, they have felt what no one can imagine. Their boys, experienced in every facet of life on the water, missing with only one clue that has surfaced, their overturned 19-foot vessel.
I would pick him to be stuck anywhere with, over any adult, over anyone. I would pick him. He is the most resourceful 14-year-old boy that I know. He's like MacGyver. I call him my MacGyver. He can make something out of anything. He is so strong-willed.
I know that the two of them together are a dynamic team, and they are figuring this out.
Both are incredibly hopeful that their sons' experiences growing up around the water will carry them in the current, keeping their survival rate high. Yet the proximity of time expiring weighs heavy.
It's terrifying to know that your child is out there without you, and that if they need help, that you can't reach out your hand and give them the help that they need. That's what being a parent is. So not being able to do that is absolutely terrifying.
What started as a small community of support has turned into a national effort filled with prayers and optimism for Perry and Austin, a symbol of hope for these two women who cling to each other and wait. Now, the family put out a message earlier tonight, really thanking everyone for the outpouring of support, for all the prayers and support that they have seen come in, not just locally, but nationally as well. They also announced that a GoFundMe page has been set up here locally for the effort to find Perry and Austin, those people who are searching with their private watercraft or personal aircraft. If you would like to help donate to that GoFundMe page, you can do so by logging on to GoFundMe.com/Perry and Austin. We logged on to it just a few minutes ago, and it's only been up for a few hours right now, and it's already up to $37,000 and counting tonight. So a lot of people absorbing that, donating to this wonderful cause here tonight. Social media, as we all know, has played a huge factor, not just getting the word out, but really identifying some of the key components of this search with regard to the Coast Guard and with regard to the family. But there's another aspect to it, a new clue the boys may have left behind on social media. We'll have that coming up at 10:30. For now, reporting live in Tequesta, I'm Jay Cashmere, Fox 29 News.
And J.R. Cruz will continue to stay on top of the latest developments on this search from Palm Beach County to the Treasure Coast in northern Florida. We'll update you with any new information both on air and online.
All right, we had some showers, thunderstorms out there earlier. Now we're seeing pretty much sky starting to clear on out. A couple showers well offshore. Temperatures right now into the lower 80s and now falling off into the upper 70s for Vero and for Fort Pierce. Still into the lower 80s for the Palm Beaches. Forecast in the morning, hour by hour, mix of sun and clouds. Some sunshine will warm us up very quickly. And yes, another round of showers and thunderstorms for tomorrow afternoon. Maybe not as many of them. I'll have more on that coming up in just a bit.
It is day four in the search for a missing North Florida toddler, and hope is fading in finding the young boy alive. 21-month-old Lonzi Barton was reported missing Friday morning by the boyfriend of the toddler's mother. He claimed the boy had been abducted when his car was stolen. Investigators, though, say 32-year-old William Ebron Jr. is lying. They arrested him Friday night and charged him with child neglect. Divers have been searching a number of retention ponds near where I-295 and I-95 meet south of Jacksonville. We're hearing chilling 911 calls from a deadly road rage shooting in Florida. Tonight, a man from Citrus County faces murder charges for pulling out a gun and shooting a father on the street in front of his family.
Some maniacs and this thing following me, trying to run me off the road. My gun's already out, it's cocked and locked.
My gun. Ma'am, I need you to get out of there.
Investigators claim Robert Doyle shot at Candelario Gonzalez five times. They're now trying to figure out what provoked the shooting.
Live in the feed room right now, we are learning about scary moments on board an American Airlines flight to Dallas when the pilot suddenly turned around just after takeoff. Here's the problem. The American Airlines flight ran into a hailstorm. You can see part of the nose here of the plane dented in there from this photo on Twitter. And this all happened, by the way, in Beijing. Right now, the airline is working to get all of those passengers booked on another flight and then back to Dallas as soon as possible. John.
Well, the Green Acres man accused of killing and chopping up his roommate will spend life behind bars. A jury found Scott Tobiasen guilty of first-degree murder today. In 2013, police say Tobiasen bludgeoned Gerald Longo to death before dismembering his body. A landscaper who intentionally ran over nine ducklings with his lawnmower will spend the next year in jail. Jason Falbo will then spend the following 3 years on probation for domestic battery. A Wellington family was feeding the ducklings in May when Falbo rode a riding lawnmower over the animals. As part of his punishment, he will never be allowed to own pets or live in a home that has pets.
A cruel crime. Next at 10, a dog suffering severe injuries, her mouth tied tight. How you can help police find her abuser.
Family of two missing teens lost at sea making a plea for your help tonight. What they're asking everyone to do to help find their boys.
Plus, a security flaw is putting millions of smartphone users at risk. How one text could take control of your phone.
LX Fox 29 has South Florida's largest news partnership, including Palm Beach Daily News.
People just can't stop talking about Ford. And now, during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on America's favorite lineup. See your local Ford dealer today.
Need cash now? CredEx may help you. Personal loans with the title of your car and you keep driving it.
CredEx.
Instant money to assist your family for legal proceedings, a medical emergency.
CredEx.
For what you need it most when you need it. If it's money you need, CredEx can help you with the title of your car and you keep driving it.
290-1700.
CredEx.
561-290-1700.
In Hollywood, Hialeah, and West Palm Beach.
Get it express the expressway to yes.
It's a golden opportunity to discover the luxury of freedom. To venture further. To experience more. To make a routine of breaking with routine. Come in to the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event, where you'll find some of the best offers of the year on our most capable models. Lease the 2015 RX 350 for $399 a month for 36 months, and we'll make your first month's payment. See your Lexus dealer.
Yeah, that's right. Deal Diva coming through. You see all my BOGOs? My weekly ad?
Just wait till you see my savings and brace yourself. The digital coupons are coming next. Look at her, so proud of her mama.
You saved quite a bit today.
Go ahead, say it.
Cha-ching! Thank you.
The weekly ad, BOGOs, and coupons. Three easy ways to save at the same place you love to shop. Publix, where shopping is a pleasure. People just can't stop talking about Ford. And now, during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on America's favorite lineup. See your local Ford dealer today.
You are fab because you are fierce and bold.
Fashionable and busy.
Funky.
And bright.
Fried eggs and bacon.
Fearless.
Flirtatious.
Fiery.
Balanced.
And brazen.
Love it.
Introducing Fab Life.
It's all about making a life more fun and beautiful.
Fab Life, starting September 14th, weekdays on Fox 29.
New tonight, a cruel crime against an innocent animal. Tonight, a dog is recovering after someone tied her mouth shut. This is the second time we've seen something like this summer. And for weeks, this dog received no food and no water. South Florida police calling it an extreme act of animal cruelty. As Sheldon Fox explains, there's a big reward to find her abuser.
Cruel, unusual, and tough to stomach. It sums up the injury to liberty.
Can't imagine anything much crueler than what was done to her. That's pretty serious injuries.
Bleeding, running, and with her face smothered and tightly bound by a muzzle when found by cops, she was reported to have been missing by her owner and then dropped off in the street, possibly by a man who drove off.
How did this dog survive? Her muzzle was so inflamed. As soon as we cut the rubber band, I mean, she took this breath of air, like, you know, she could finally breathe.
She was found more than a week ago by police on West Sunrise Boulevard. Her deep wounds to her jowls so bad, there was an initial fear that infection could threaten her life.
No, this dog's been given a second chance, and it's nothing but sunshine and rainbows for her. Well, that animal abuser is on the loose tonight. Coral Springs Police offering a reward for their capture. You can help by sharing this post on the Fox 29 Facebook page.
New clues tonight in that deadly Louisiana movie theater shooting. The gunman's journal discovered inside his motel room, now giving investigators a look inside his plan. New photos show John Hauser's trashed hotel room. Police found wigs and glasses in that room, which they now believe Hauser used while scoping out other theaters in the area. Hauser killed two women and injured nine during his attack at the theater before turning the gun on himself. Tonight, detectives still examining that motel room and the theater in hopes of learning more about his possible motive for the attack.
Big changes coming for the Boy Scouts of America. Tonight, the organization officially allowing gay scout leaders. It comes 2 years after the controversial decision to allow openly gay members as scouts. Now, under the new policy, gay leaders previously removed due to their sexual orientation can reapply for volunteer positions.
A warning tonight about who you give your phone number to. We've just learned a flaw in Android devices allows hackers to infiltrate your phone. The bug, nicknamed Stage Fright, allows a hacker to steal your phone's data and photos or hijack your phone's microphone and camera. All they have to do is send a malware-laced multimedia message. You don't even have to click on anything or even be made aware that you got the message. Now, Google is aware of the bug and has already taken some precautions to fix it.
Jane's a downpour earlier today.
Yeah.
At least where I was. I was in downtown West Palm, and I mean, it was coming down.
Tough rush hour going home also.
Oh, yeah,
right?
Yeah. A lot of people had two, three of them all in a row with in between some sunshine. So we're trying to break this drought out here, and this is definitely a good step in the right direction. Rain totals across the area, about a half an inch. Some folks, of course, saw none. But at the airport, about a half an inch. My house, 0.62, so a little bit more than others. But looking at outside right now on the live Fox cam, we're just looking at still some wet streets out there. Hasn't had a chance to really dry up before the sunset. And not a whole lot of rain at the moment. Temperatures hovering around 80 degrees, 80 in Fort Pierce, but 78 in Vero, 77 in Okeechobee, Boca, 82 degrees. I don't expect much rain tonight. But again, tomorrow we will see some scattered afternoon showers and thunderstorms. I think there'll be a little bit less, though. A little bit of drier air starting to inch its way in here from the Bahamas. And that may give us a little bit of a reprieve tomorrow with just some isolated showers and storms. The focus mainly on the Treasure Coast. See, low pressure trying to form here into the Gulf. And really, this entire area is kind of elongated low pressure draped across us. And that keeps unsettled weather around. And it's really not moving all that much. So we're looking for some higher rain chances as we go in through the week. Check out ViperCast. We'll start in the morning. Notice we'll see a lot of sunshine. Going through the afternoon, some scattered showers and storms. A lot of it just on the Treasure Coast, and notice a lot less than what we saw out there today. Then we bump it back up for Wednesday. Better chances for rain going into Wednesday afternoon as we see a lot more coverage, at least of them, on Wednesday. So those rain chances do bump back up on Wednesday, a little bit down Thursday, and then we stay steady into the weekend with still unsettled weather. The tropics, very quiet, hardly even cloud cover in the Caribbean, a little bit in the Gulf and the Atlantic. That's where we're focused right now to see if this thing, some of the models did want to spin this up into a tropical system here off the coast. But now, maybe not so much. It will just be a weak area of low pressure, still something to watch here going into the next week or so before we can finally get rid of it. Afternoon showers and storms for the boaters out there. Again, those will be moving from the mainland quickly to the offshore waters. Seas only 1 to 3 feet, but inside any of those thunderstorms, you'll get some very gusty winds and some rough seas. Morning sun for the beachgoers out there, and a lot of us will see an all-day beach day with isolated scattered showers and storms again arriving in the afternoon and evening. 7-day forecast, high temperatures, low to middle 90s with a little bit more sun tomorrow and still that southwest wind. Well, we're really going to get hot with the low to middle 90s. And again, rain chances lasting on in through the weekend.
Next at 10, a new search for clues after two local boys get lost at sea. What their family wants you to do tonight that could help solve this mystery.
And forget first class, the new upgrade that takes you off the airplane and onto a private jet.
Look at me, son. I'm talking to you.
Plus, hot on the web, meet the officer whose message to a criminal is going viral tonight.
The Nissan Rogue. With blind spot warning, a round view monitor, and intuitive all-wheel drive that knows just when to kick in. Choose Rogue, just $219 per month, or get 0% APR for up to 60 months. Nissan, innovation that excites. Shop ChooseNissan.com.
When it drives and looks like new, you'll want to treat it like new. Certified pre-owned by BMW.
Now at Bremen BMW, get 0.9% financing, and BMW makes your first two payments.
A rabbit. A rabbit genetically modified and bred with a panther. With turbines attached. On ice. Shaved. With a... What the...
With the fastest speeds to the most homes, the company that keeps making fast faster is doing it again. Introducing multi-gig speeds from Xfinity, the future of awesome.
Welcome to AutoNation.com. With AutoNation Express, you can get an actual car with a real price in just 5 easy steps. 1. Shop nearly 100,000 vehicles. 2. Lock in your price on the actual car. 3. Go reserve it here. 4. Visit your AutoNation showroom. 5. Drive it home. Thanks to AutoNation Express, save time, save hassle, save money. People paid less at AutoNation.
Nice!
Chevy's got 3 great deals to choose from this summer. Which works the best with your budget?
I'm drawn to the 0%.
$1,000 cash back.
I've never ever thought about leasing a car until I saw that deal.
Now let me tell you something that's super cool. You can choose any one of these deals on any of these cars.
Seriously?
Find your tag, get $2,500 total cash allowance on select Cruise vehicles in stock. Or current qualified GM lessees can get this Chevy Cruze LT for around $169 a month.
Weather on the go. Text weather to 29,000. Sponsored by your South Florida Honda dealers.
Trending right now, Delta Airlines is cooking up what may be one of the most appealing flight upgrades yet. One that allows you to bag a commercial flight altogether and then board a private jet. The new upgrade program will cost anywhere from $300 to $800, depending on where you're going. Passengers who have elite or medallion status, you guys will be eligible for the offers starting as soon as this week. And a parent barters with his teens to clean up their mess with a Taken-inspired note. Dad enlisted the help of Liam Neeson to threaten to take away the teenagers' internet access if they didn't wash the dishes. The note said, if they don't, quote, I will look for you, I will find you, and I will disconnect you. The Indiana dad says he finds being humorous more effective than being like a drill sergeant.
Look at me, son. I'm talking to you. The sheriff likes Deli's restaurant, and so do I. The food here is good, and the folks are friendly. We're going to identify you, arrest you, and put you in a small cell. After that, I'm going to have a cheeseburger here with fries and a Coke and leave a nice tip for the waitress. Meanwhile, your next meal will be served through a small hole in a cell door.
I think this guy needs a TV show. I don't know about you, but an officer in Louisiana is on his way to viral fame after this unusual but kind of heartwarming Crime Stoppers video about a man who burglarized a restaurant pretty popular with local police there. Lieutenant Higgins, that's him, went on to say that they did collect DNA evidence from a rock used to smash glass to get in there. And then they also got a perfect boot print. So he says he's confident this criminal will be caught. So far, thousands of people have watched this video online and they've liked it too.
Now that was funny.
I know. He's awesome. He's a great character. I'm telling you, a reality show.
No nonsense.
No. Serious. No. Down to business.
Small cell.
They're going to catch
where your next meal's coming from. More nonstop news still ahead at 10.
We're digging deeper into the mystery at sea. Two local teens missing after a day on the water. Could their final social media messages be crucial clues?
And then I Snapchat him, he didn't reply. So then that made me even more nervous.
Then, giving a suspect a snack landed a Florida officer in big trouble. Why video of him feeding a homeless man is making people sick. Banned for life, the mistake one Florida man made that got him kicked out of Starbucks forever. Plus,
they're on me too.
There it is.
Bees terrorizing a neighborhood where they believe all the bugs are coming from.
When you've been in a relationship for a while, things can get predictable. But I promise you, when I come back this fall, I'll surprise you every day.
Surprise! I'm here to spread the love!
How's everybody doing? Steve Harvey, fourth season. We spread love this year.
It's what I do, baby.
Weekdays at 5 on Fox 29.
People just can't stop talking about Ford. And now, during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on America's favorite lineup. See your local Ford dealer today.
Jeffy1016 posted,
worked hard, promotion, time to play hard. Hashtag upgrade my car.
Congrats, Jeffy. Now's the time to hit the Honda Summer Clearance Event. You can get a great deal on the Honda Accord from KBB.com's best overall brand. With rear view camera and text message reader standard, it's the perfect upgrade.
Awesome.
Go, Jeffy. Go, Jeffy.
Hurry in to the Honda Summer Clearance Event for a great deal on your new Honda.
Well, well, if it isn't the belle of the ball.
Gentlemen, you look well.
What's new, Flo?
Well, a Name Your Price tool went missing last week.
Name Your what now?
It gives you coverage options based on your budget. I just hope whoever stole it knows that it only works at Progressive.com.
So you can't use it to just buy stuff?
No.
I'm sorry, Gustav. We have to go back to the pet store. He's gonna meet us there.
The Name Your Price tool. Still only at Progressive.com.
It's here! The official Raymond Honda Summer Clearance Event. Now pick your payment on 11 acres of Hondas, the low payment that's right for you. Get this great summer clearance deal right now.
New Hondas from as low as $69 a month.
Mike Rodriguez has the best clearance savings right now. How do I know that? Because he's my dad. Your low Honda price out the door. That's the Bremen Honda bottom line.
People just can't stop talking about Ford. And now, during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on America's favorite lineup. See your local Ford dealer today.
Tonight's weather is sponsored by CMI Air Conditioning. We provide service when you need it. Call CMI 844-1004. Now, Fox Midnight News at 10 p.m. continues.
New clues in the search for two missing teens from our area. The 14-year-olds have been lost at sea for 3 days now.
Our Jay Cashmere live in Tequesta outside the family's home where they are waiting for any new information tonight. Jay.
Yeah, John and Ashley, they've been waiting for 3 days now, holding out hope for the safe and immediate return of Perry and Austin, as you mentioned, now missing for over 3 days. The Coast Guard continuing their search effort tonight, that massive and aggressive search effort off the coast of Jacksonville. They'll continue throughout tonight and into tomorrow. We're told that we could have a press conference from the Coast Guard in Miami sometime tomorrow. A time on that has not been given just yet. But locally, there's been a big request from the Coast Guard for video. Anyone living north of the Jupiter Inlet, whether it be in Jupiter Inlet Colony, Jupiter Island, or perhaps if you live along the Jupiter Inlet, if you have surveillance video that runs constantly in your home that either points toward the ocean or the intercoastal or perhaps the inlet, the Coast Guard is asking to see that video. Perhaps last Friday, if it was recording, those moments could be crucial in helping to find those two young boys. So if you fit that description or you have video that fits that description, call the Coast Guard. They'd like to take a look at that video. As we all know, social media has been huge in this search and rescue effort underway, but there's a big component to night of it that's raising some red flags. Could the teens' final Snapchat messages provide some crucial clues? Brian Enton talked to some of the boys' friends tonight, and they say that their final social media posts were alarming.
I talked to him Thursday night. I was supposed to hang out with him Thursday afternoon, and then come Friday, he's missing.
Friends of 14-year-old Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen say Austin's final Snapchat Friday was concerning.
One of the other Snapchats I saw that he deleted right away said that, or didn't really say anything. It just showed the water. Then he pointed up behind him and a storm moved in real fast.
A storm moving in the photo, and soon after, the boys would be gone.
Made me a little bit nervous. And then I Snapchatted him, he didn't reply, so then that made me even more nervous.
Friends say Austin also Snapchatted about leaving Jupiter.
I saw Snapchat not referencing the Bahamas, but saying peace out, Jup, and usually when we all say peace out, Jup, we mean going to the Bahamas.
They joked before about boating to the Bahamas alone, but never actually did it, and their parents don't believe they would leave the area unless they got into trouble.
Nervous. I have confidence in them, though.
Confidence that keeps these young teens hopeful that the final Snapchats were not the last time they'll see their friends. Brian Enton, Fox 29 News.
Looking for any evidence to help in the search and rescue effort anywhere they can find it. Here's a timetable of how we got to where we are tonight. This all started Friday afternoon. Austin and Perry last seen Friday afternoon in Jupiter filling up the boat with gasoline. That was around 1:30 in the afternoon. Now, the Coast Guard says they first received reports of the boys missing at 5 p.m., and that's when they initiated their search. That search continued through stormy weather on Saturday, and then yesterday, their overturned 19-foot vessel was found around 11 o'clock in the morning, and the boys' parents confirmed that it was in fact their boat yesterday afternoon, and that boat was in fact Austin and Perry's. And of course, that's where the Coast Guard then honed their search and rescue efforts in, studying the Gulf Stream, studying the currents, really mobilizing their grid up toward Jacksonville, right along the Florida-Georgia line there, and that's where they continue their efforts tonight. Meanwhile, the family back here holding out hope, waiting for good news. We're going to have much more on this continuing story, all the latest developments coming up in 30 minutes on our partner station, WPTV News Channel 5 at 11. For now, I'm Jay Cashmere reporting live in Tequesta for Fox 29 News. Back to you.
So thanks all news tonight. A Florida officer caught on camera tossing food at a prisoner. And now that officer is under investigation. Haley Hines has the shocking report.
It's like something you'd see at the circus, someone tossing peanuts into an animal's mouth. But this is no circus. It's the Sarasota County Jail, and this is no animal. It's Randy Miller. The homeless man was arrested July 18th for trespassing outside a convenience store. Handcuffed behind his back and intoxicated, he waits to be booked. That's when Sarasota police officer Andrew Halpin begins tossing peanuts toward Miller's mouth. Most bounce onto the floor. One of three men watching behind the desk walks over to hand Halpin more, and the game continues. Later in the video, Miller, clearly hungry, slumps down onto his knees, even rolling on his side, just to eat a few small nuts from the floor.
I feel bad for him at this point. Or at least that, like, nobody's at least helping him get the peanuts. They're always kind of standing there.
Sarasota Police Chief Bernadette DePino says she is disappointed in what she saw in the video and immediately initiated an internal affairs investigation. In the meantime, Officer Halpin has been placed on paid administrative leave.
It wasn't a heinous crime, but it was ridiculous in a sense.
The video strikes a chord with local homeless advocates like Leslie Loveless, the executive director of Suncoast Partnership to End Homelessness. She agrees the chief did the right thing in suspending the officer, saying we will never solve community problems by degrading and humiliating other people. Discrimination takes many forms and is as old as time.
If he could have thrown the peanuts at that guy, then he probably could have offered him some instead of being rude about it.
Now, the sheriff's office is also assisting in this investigation.
It is a grande problem for a Starbucks fan from Tampa. He's been banned for life from his favorite coffee shop. Rob Rowan was allegedly harassing other customers about parking in the handicapped spot. He says the manager sent him a letter telling him to stay away for good.
So here's the letter. It's a notice of expulsion and warning against trespassing. And it says, I've been expelled from Starbucks Coffee Company locations for the reasons listed above.
Now, Rowan admits when he saw someone park illegally, he'd take a cell phone picture of the alleged violation, then confront the driver inside. Well, now he'll have to find somewhere else to get his short decaf non-fat with whip boca. Starbucks said it is working with the landlord of the property to improve the parking situation. Tomorrow, we'll be getting a closer look at sunken treasure found off our coast. More than $1 million worth of gold artifacts recovered near Sebastian. And the artifacts found in the 1715 fleet wreck sites. And the centerpiece of the find, a single coin called a royal made for the King of Spain, Philip V. Treasure hunters will talk about their find tomorrow at Captain Hiram's in Sebastian.
Next at 10, bees are terrorizing a neighborhood where they believe all the bugs are coming from.
A terrifying sight at a mall, how this mother saved her son's life moments before losing her own.
Plus, we're going to explain why so many people are going ape over this new zoo video.
Spending on a complete pair of no-line bifocals, $250, $400, maybe even $550? Well, how about 99? Two-pair no-line bifocals for $99 plus free eye exam. Stanton Optical. Call 1-800-STANTON for nearest location.
Carly posts,
breaking up with the longest relationship I've ever had. Hashtag sad but true.
Good riddance, Carly.
Hashtag 96 months too long.
Oh, the car. Right. Well, now is a perfect time to head over to the Honda Summer Clearance Event. We've got great deals on the Honda Civic, the best-selling car in its class. So ditch that loser.
Hey.
Still talking about the car.
Hurry in to the Honda Summer Clearance Event for a great deal on your new Honda.
When account lead Craig Wilson books at LaQuinta.com, he gets a ready fueler the second his room is ready. So he knows exactly when he can settle in and practice his big pitch. And when Craig gets his pitch down pat, do you know what he becomes?
Great proposal. Let's talk more over golf.
Great.
Better yet, how about over tennis?
Even better.
A game changer.
Your 2 o'clock is here.
Oops. Hold your horses. No problem.
La Quinta Inns and Suites is ready for you, so you'll be ready for business. The Ready For You alert only at LQ.com.
La Quinta.
Everybody talks, everybody talks. It started with the whisper.
People just can't stop talking about Ford. And now, during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on Ford Focus with EcoBoost.
EcoBoost went super fast.
Ford is the brand more people buy and buy again. So don't miss the Ford Summer Sales Event. Now get a Ford Focus for $149 a month for 36 months with only $1,949 due at signing for current competitive lessees. Only at your South Florida Ford stores.
It's a golden opportunity to elevate each moment. Hit every mark. Thread every needle. Turn every ride into a thrill ride. Come in to the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event, where you'll find some of the best offers of the year on our most exhilarating models, Lease the 2015 IS250 for $349 a month for 36 months, and we'll make your first month's payment. See your Lexus dealer.
Simply no match.
Two pair of eyeglasses for $69 plus a free eye exam. Call 800 Stanton for nearest location.
This high-definition newscast is sponsored by Napleton's West Palm Beach Hyundai at the big corner of Okeechobee Boulevard and Congress Avenue.
All right, let's take a look at the stories making headlines around the world in 90 seconds. A terrifying sight caught on camera in China. A mother saves her son seconds before falling to her death inside an escalator shaft. Now, security cameras capturing this woman and her son riding the escalator. And as she gets ready to step off, you see a panel suddenly collapses under her feet. She pushed her son forward. He was quickly pulled to safety by a mall employee. Now, we're not going to show you the rest of the video, but seconds later, the woman disappeared through that hole. We're told that maintenance workers forgot to screw that panel into place. President Obama continuing his tour of the African continent in Ethiopia. In the first ever visit by a U.S. president to this country, the president talked counterterrorism, regional security, and human rights issues. Asked about Ethiopia's human rights record, Obama said the Ethiopian prime minister, quote, will indicate I don't bite my tongue much when it comes to these issues. The hunt is on for the man who killed Cecil, a 13-year-old lion and tourist attraction in Zimbabwe's safari industry. Cecil was lured away from the protection of a national park and shot. A safari tourist is suspected. Take a look at this, a scary landing as a KLM plane banked sharply just a few feet over the runway as the pilots struggled to land the plane here in high winds. Now, the Boeing 777 did touch down, landing taking place as a violent summer storm hit the Netherlands. That's a look at what's happening around the world.
In the Fox Light tonight, the initial autopsy results on Bobby Christina Brown show no significant injuries and no obvious cause of death. The 22-year-old daughter of Whitney Houston and Bobby Brown died this weekend. Bobby Brown breaking his silence today, speaking through his attorney and saying in part, quote, Chrissy was and is an angel. I am completely numb at this time. My family must find a way to live with her in spirit and honor her memory.
Still ahead of 10, bees on the attack in one neighborhood, the unusual place that these bugs were coming from.
Hot on the web. We're going to explain why so many people are going ape over this new zoo video.
No rain out there right now on the radar, but it does look like rain will return. Find out all about it in my complete forecast coming up again in just a few minutes.
In sale, Mullinex Ford will sell our 500,000th vehicle. That's enough cars to reach from Miami to Maine. Why have so many chosen Mullinex? You get a great low price right up front. No dealer fees and huge selection for four floors of Fords at no dealer fees. Mullinex Ford.
Oh, is Mr. Bear joining us for dinner?
Yeah, bears like salmon too.
Well, this is very special salmon, Mr. Bear. It's only around for a little while.
Sounds good.
Would you like a whole piece so you can share with Mr. Bear?
Yes, please.
So, Mr. Bear?
Mommy, Mr. Bear says he likes ice cream too.
But Mr. Bear has to finish his salmon first.
Okay.
Okay.
Publix Fresh Wild Alaskan Sockeye Salmon is never frozen, but it won't be around long, so enjoy it while it's here. Only at Publix, where shopping is a pleasure.
Run! I'm coming.
Let's go, Dad.
Who's ready to go to Wally World?
It's a long way down Holiday Road. Oh, Holiday Road.
Honey, a blonde in a convertible? Seriously?
Built for families, designed for drivers. Lease the 7-seat Infiniti QX60 for $399 a month. Visit your local Infiniti retailer.
Every day, you're breathing 20,000 breaths. Do you know what you're breathing in? Your indoor air can be 2 to 5 times worse than outdoor air. Filtrete Healthy Living Filters can help improve your indoor air quality with exclusive Filtrete brand 3-in-1 technology from 3M to pull in and trap unwanted particles, letting cleaner air flow through. Every breath is a reason to care about your air. So make every breath count with Filtrete Filters.
Everybody talks, everybody talks. It started with the
people just can't stop talking about Ford. And now during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on Ford Escape with one-of-a-kind features.
It opened without my hand.
fun.
And escape his highest-ranked compact SUV in initial quality in a Tide by J.D. Power. Now get an Escape for only $209 a month for 36 months with $2634 due at signing for current competitive lessees. Only at your South Florida Ford stores.
During the Mullinex Ford 1/2 million sale, we're celebrating by giving away a new 2015 F-150 or Mustang Premium. Everything is on sale, even the all-new F-150. Save $10,000 on F-150 XLT Super Cruise. That's $10,000 for four floors of Fords and no dealer fees. Mullinex Ford.
My Fox 29 app is reporting severe weather. Power in your hand, Dad.
Power on the road, Brent.
The Fox 29 mobile app and the Ford F-150, powered by Mullinex Ford.
They're everywhere.
Is it still in your hair?
They're on me, too.
There it is.
Yikes, a backyard beehive causing chaos in an Albuquerque, New Mexico neighborhood. People who live there say their kids, their dogs, everyone, even the reporter there, is under attack. Some people getting stung 5 times a day. The culprit? Beehives in a neighbor's tree. Even the photojournalist shooting this story got stung.
I got stung shooting your story. Bro.
So where are all these bees coming from? Oh, God.
I have bees. Right now, I don't have any.
That you have a ton of them swarming you right now.
You don't have any? Look at them. They're all over him. Well, the man says he'd been ordered to remove his hives and says he has, although, as you can see, evidence suggests otherwise.
Oh. All right, how about this? When an orangutan puckered up against a pregnant woman's belly, well, of course, those who viewed the video went ape. Jeannie Most reports on a belly-kissing primate.
Consider this pause pregnant. Yes, this really is an orangutan at the Colchester Zoo in England kissing a pregnant woman's belly twice. Before Jamie Clark, the father, started recording with his cell phone, the 47-year-old male orangutan named Rajang actually pointed at Maisie Knight's belly.
He started rubbing her belly with his finger, just like that.
And then came the kiss, which Maisie describes as a nice feeling. It's now gone viral.
I just keep getting tagged all over Facebook that my belly's famous.
Jamie offered the orangutan his belly, but the ape wasn't interested and shooed away his hand. But pregnant women have repeatedly caught his eye, posted one. This is also how I found out I was pregnant. He kept kissing my tummy and pointing, so I went home, done a test, which was positive. And a mother posted her daughter's photo saying, Rajang kept touching her pregnant stomach through the glass and didn't take his eyes off her baby bump. The zoo says that when the staff was first issued shorts, Rajang became fixated on legs and knees. He's also intrigued by cuts and bruises. So if you go visit, strip off those band-aids. Maisie is expecting a boy any day. You're not going to name him Rajang.
No.
She may be expecting, but she wasn't expecting this. Jeannie Mo, CNN, New York.
All right. Outside right now, we're looking at a mainly fair sky. Still some puddles around, too. Picked up 1/2 inch plus across the area. In some spots, other spots, didn't see a whole lot. But still, there was a lot of scattered rain around. We'll see some tomorrow. Just maybe not as many people will see them tomorrow. Temperatures now upper 70s for the Treasure Coast. Still hovering at 80, though, in Port St. Lucie, 77. In Okeechobee, 80 in West Palm, 81 in Boynton Beach, a couple showers offshore. Here's forecast for tomorrow, mid-70s. We're starting off in partly sunny skies. Then in the afternoon, here come the rains. Better chance along the Treasure Coast than the Palm Beaches, but still some scattered showers and thunderstorms expected. High temperatures into the lower 90s. If you don't see the rain, you'll continue to climb with those temperatures and most likely hit the middle 90s with heat indices over 100 degrees. So very warm and tropical and muggy out there. A low pressure trying to form here off the coast into the Gulf of Mexico, kind of elongated low moving all the way through the state and right through the middle of the state. The most moisture. We're starting to get a little bit of dry air working its way in from the Bahamas for extreme South Florida. That may edge up in the Palm Beach County tomorrow, not allowing quite as many showers and storms to form. But I still think this Treasure Coast will see a good deal of them out there, too. We had a couple waves of them move through. two or three of them actually, through Palm Beach County today. Here's Vipercast starting off the day with partly sunny skies and then scattered showers and thunderstorms developing throughout the afternoon. And again, generally moving from the west back to the coastline. And even on Wednesday, we look for more of the same, with starting off with sunshine, and then here comes the showers and storms pushing from west to east. We stick with this pattern really for the next several days, all the way through the end of the week with these higher rain chances. Good for our drought though. We can use some good soakers out there, super soakers out there going in through the week and even on into the weekend. Tropics remain quiet. Nothing really into the Caribbean. Out in the Atlantic, nothing there either. And we're just watching this kind of elongated low pressure here. There's a low way up here and another one trying to form here, but nothing really going on at the moment, nor is it expected to really spark up into something big. So tropics will remain quiet. Boating forecast, be aware of those afternoon and evening thunderstorms and the beach forecast too. Otherwise, you'll see a lot of sun in the morning. 7-day forecast, similar weather pattern throughout the week. Low to middle 90s with afternoon storms.
Coming up at the Ford Sports Zone, another Marlins star making a rehab start in Jupiter, plus a Cardinal Newman grad training for an NFL rebirth. Emerson shares his story after the break.
Lex, Fox 29, Indian River Press Journal, and TCPalm.com, the largest news partnership on the Treasure Coast.
Looks like the Garcias got a new car.
What'd they get?
I don't know.
Sure doesn't look like a Buick.
Buick.
I'm outside. Where are you?
I'm right here. I'm in the Buick.
I don't see a Buick.
Take a fresh look at Buick. It just might surprise you.
That's not a Buick. That's what I told him.
Wow. This is nice.
Oh, my.
Now current lessees. Switch to Buick and lease this 2015 Enclave for around $298 a month.
The Iran nuclear deal. Good deal or bad deal? Iran keeps their nuclear facilities. Military sites can go uninspected. Restrictions end after 10 years. Then Iran could build a nuclear weapon in 2 months. Iran has violated 20 international agreements and is the leading state sponsor of terrorism. Congress should reject a bad deal. We need a better deal.
Nice.
Chevy's got three great deals to choose from this summer. Which works the best with your budget?
I'm drawn to the 0%.
$1,000 cash back.
I've never ever thought about leasing a car until I saw that deal.
Now let me tell you something that's super cool. You can choose any one of these deals on any of these cars.
Seriously?
Find your tag, get $2,500 total cash allowance on select Cruise vehicles in stock. Or current qualified GM lessees can get this Chevy Cruise LT for around $169 a month.
Nissan Altima. With up to 270 horsepower, blind spot warning, and premium interior. For a limited time, lease Altima, just $179 per month, or save up to $3,525. Altima, the ride you can always rely on. Shop your local Nissan store and choose Nissan.com. Innovation that excites.
Johnny, what happened?
Too many fireworks.
Well, get ready for even more bang for your buck.
More?
A Regal summer clearance event is going on now.
With more explosive savings?
Yep, with all savings clearly marked on over 3,500 new Dodge, Chrysler, Jeeps, and Rams. It's one easy, no hassle, no pressure buying experience.
Do our banks still want to say yes, you're approved?
Definitely. Now go get cleaned up.
I'm going to get some more fireworks.
Oh, no.
You got to go to Regal.
West Palm.
Fort Pierce.
Sawgrass.
You're in the zone. The Ford Sports Zone from the team at ESPN 106.3.
Well, in 5 days, every NFL team will be back on the field for good.
Thank you.
Training camps are here, each franchise chasing the dream of reaching Super Bowl 50. But for Cardinal Newman grad Jacoby Ford, what he's chasing is another NFL contract. Tonight, on his 28th birthday, the West Palm Beach native is grinding hard this offseason. Ford has been working out with world-class trainer Tony Villani in Boca Raton, and it's paying off because the former Oakland wide receiver with track star speed was just invited to Tennessee's training camp, and after spending last season out of the NFL, Ford's ready to make the most of his shot with the Titans.
You know, it's not easy to stay in this league. You know, once you get there, you know, you have to do a lot of little things to stay, and that's something that You know, I think I took for granted a little bit at first, but, you know, just kind of humbled me and put me back into, you know, perspective of, like, you know, you got to go back and just start doing everything right.
Ford and the rest of Tennessee reporting for training camp on Friday. FAU football playing host to a specialist camp on Monday. Kickers, punters, long snappers perfecting their craft, taking lessons from renowned teacher Jamie Cole. He's helped guys like Dolphins kicker Caleb Sturgis make an NFL roster. It's a lonely, pressure-packed position that Coach Partridge says deserves a lot of credit.
It's critical. I mean, from field position on kickoff to obviously scoring points on extra points and field goals, it's critical. And you know, in today's day and age, there's an expectation for them to make it, let's be honest. And unfortunately for them, a lot of times they get more press when they don't make it as opposed to when they do, unless it's a certain situation. So they need to be able to perform with that in mind.
Well, Owls open up fall camp 1 week from tonight. Marlins second baseman and leadoff hitter D. Gordon continues to work his way back from a dislocated thumb. And if all goes well in his rehab start tonight, he could be clear to join Miami as soon as tomorrow. The 27-year-old speedster doing work with the Jupiter Hammerheads at Roger Dean Stadium. Only one for four in the night. His only hit coming in the third, a throwing error. So Gordon ends up landing at third, but Big Blue says, got to head back to second, son. Highlight of the night, though, coming before the game when DG buys the entire team Cuban food for dinner.
I got it for him the night in the second game, so hopefully they enjoy it. Well, it was pretty good right here, so, you know, clubhouse guy recommended it.
I guarantee you everybody on the team's like, hey, D, I know you need a few more days to rehab.
Right, right.
We're hungry. Feel free to do that more often.
Emerson, thanks so much.
You got it.
Kelly Dunn live in the newsroom now with a look at what's coming up on News Channel 5 at 11. Kelly?
Guys, continuing to follow the big story, not only here, but in many parts of the country, and that is the search for the two young teenagers from Tequesta who disappeared Friday night after taking off on their 19-foot fishing boat. We'll have the very latest from Jacksonville to the search here, to the beautiful show of support that happened along the shore tonight. All that and more coming up at 11 o'clock.
Thank you, Kelly, and thank you for joining us.
Stay tuned for News Channel 5 at 11 for more local news. Have a great night.
Everybody talks. It started with the wheel. People just can't stop talking about Ford. And now, during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on America's favorite lineup. See your local Ford dealer today.
I really shouldn't. No, you know what? I should. And I will. I deserve this. I'm a BOGO finding, weekly ad flipping, couponing mastermind. Who's saving big time? This girl.
Can I help you?
Indeed. This queen of savings deserves a reward.
A cannoli, please.
The weekly ad, BOGOs, and coupons. Three easy ways to save at the same place you love to shop. Publix, where shopping is a pleasure.
A new season brings a new look. A chance to try something different. This summer, challenge your preconceptions and experience a Cadillac for yourself.
The 2015 Cadillac SRX. Current GM lessees can lease this from around $339 per month or.
Wow.
Just to say, to clarify, I did that for England.
You know, she's tough. She's fun, but she's also so modest. And for me, this has just been a total privilege. And I'm pleased to be able to deliver her safely back to her family in one piece.
You ready for some fun?
Burn rubber, honey.
I definitely feel as though I needed something like this because, you know, so much of my life is looking after everybody else. But this, for me, has been time for myself, and I feel invigorated by it, as well as sort of nice and calm and empowered and all those really good things. Bear, you rock. Let's do it again.
Next Monday, Vacation star Ed Helms is used to getting laughs.
I'm allergic to cats. That probably means that there is a cougar circling us right now.
But in the wild.
This is probably the worst place you can be if you're scared of heights.
Oh my God!
This comedian will need to hang on
What is this, Pirates of the Caribbean?
To more than his sense of humor.
I'm not afraid to cook Bear Grylls for dinner. I will grill Bear.
Running Wild with Bear Grylls, next Monday here on NBC.
On an all-new Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, Tom Cruise drops by. NBC Tonight.
Families of two missing teens not giving up.
We don't give up. You know, this is about our children, and we believe in them.
We have no other option but to remain positive. Our boys will come home to us.
The Coast Guard remaining positive Austin and Perry could survive.
In a warm water, you can survive for quite a few days.
The community lighting up the sky, waiting for their return.
Family and friends are staying strong. They're hoping Perry Cohen and Austin Stefanos will be found.
But 3 days after the teens left the Jupiter Inlet to go fishing, there is still no sign of the 14-year-olds. Tonight, the Coast Guard getting a better idea of where to search. We have team coverage from Palm Beach County to Jacksonville.
We begin with News Channel 5's Jay Cashmere live, where the boys' families are waiting for word from the Coast Guard. Jay?
John Kelly, the small village of Tequesta and the surrounding town of Jupiter holding out hope tonight for the survival of Perry and Austin. Behind me here, the families have gathered. We've seen a lot of foot traffic in and out here all evening long. They are holding out hope. They are praying and supporting one another. They've been waiting for 3 days now for answers, hoping for good news. Tonight, the Coast Guard continues its massive and aggressive search off the coast of Jacksonville, where yesterday a big clue was found. The boys' 19-foot vessel was found some 70 miles off the coast there. And tonight, given all the wind factors, given the drifts, the currents, and the Gulf Stream, the Coast Guard is focusing their efforts right along the Florida-Georgia line where they feel they might be able to find these young men. That is the best opportunity that they have here tonight. We'll begin up in Jacksonville tonight with News Channel 5's Michelle Quesada. She is standing by live at the Coast Guard station up there with more on the search and rescue effort. Michelle.
Jay, a Jacksonville Coast Guard cutter from this station has now joined the search. The Coast Guard has searched more than 28,000 square miles off the coast of Jupiter and all the way up to Jacksonville. I've talked to people here in Atlantic Beach who say they're just learning about Perry and Austin's disappearance, and they're hoping the Coast Guard will find the boys soon.
Butcher and Buddy Duncan share the same passion for fishing that Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen do. Now they're learning, along with other Jacksonville locals, that the Coast Guard is searching off the coast for the 14-year-olds missing from Jupiter since Friday.
That's pretty scary. I mean, we're out here all the time, and even the current just along here will pull you out.
Video released today by the Coast Guard shows the 19-foot-long boat the teens took out of the Jupiter Inlet capsized 67 miles east of the Ponce Inlet near Cape Canaveral.
Yeah, just confirm nobody's on board.
Not too far from the boat was a life vest.
We are hopeful that maybe they both have life jackets on.
The Coast Guard says the teens were believed to be on their way to the Bahamas on a fishing trip and were used to taking out their boat. Still, Butcher, who fishes often, says it's a challenging task no matter how much experience you have.
You have to be smart. You have to know your tides. You have to know where you're at. Have the right gears.
The Coast Guard says finding the boat helped crews on five different cutters and aircrafts adjust the search zone. They are hopeful that the teens could survive in warm water for about 4 to 5 days.
People can survive in the water. It's relatively warm, but again, it's a dangerous environment, and there's only so long you could stay in the water.
Crews will be searching throughout the night and all day tomorrow. The Coast Guard has not said whether it will expand the search north of Jacksonville. They're taking search efforts one day at a time. Reporting live from the Coast Guard station here in Mayport, Atlantic Beach, Michelle Quesada, WPTV News Channel 5. Jay, back to you.
Michelle, thank you very much. We're back here in Tequesta and in Jupiter. Both communities came out here tonight in support of this family to help find Perry and Austin. They lit up the sky with lanterns as a beacon of hope, in part to light the way home for Perry and Austin. News Channel 5's Alyssa Heineman was there at the vigil today, where friends are not giving up. Alyssa.
Tonight, hundreds gathered at the Jupiter Inlet to light lanterns, a small but powerful symbol as they hope to help light the way home.
God, you're still in charge.
More prayers for Perry and Austin.
Everyone said,
amen.
As illuminated lanterns floated up above the Jupiter Inlet Monday night.
I know that everyone here still has hope,
and they got still in control.
There's still no signs of 14-year-olds Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen, the two sequestered teens who went missing from a fishing trip sometime Friday.
It was devastating when I found out. Like, I didn't believe it. I was like, no, they're on the boat all the time. Like, how could this have happened?
And tonight, from the very spot the boys left, an entire community united together to light up the night.
Hopefully, like the lanterns will fly far enough that they'll be able to see them and just know that we're still looking for them.
A small but powerful display in the sky that there's still hope for the boys' safe return home.
Just in case the boys are out there and they see that light, they know we're waiting for them to come home and that no one's forgotten about them.
Now, this event was actually organized just hours before it came together, and that's just a testament to how much support these boys have in this community. Reporting live in Tequesta, Alyssa Hyman, WPTV News Channel 5.
Alyssa, thank you very much. Well, two people who have remained vigilant, wrapped in hope that their sons will return safe and alive, are the mothers of Perry and Austin. They have come together in unimaginable ways, hoping and keeping an image in their head that one day, very soon, Perry and Austin will walk right back into this community where they grew up. The bond between Carly Black and Pamela Cohen can't get any stronger.
No one understands what I'm going through, but Pamela, and vice versa, and we have to stick together.
For 3 days and counting, they have felt what no one can imagine. Their boys, experienced in every facet of life on the water, missing with only one clue that has surfaced, their overturned 19-foot vessel.
I would pick him to be stuck anywhere with, over any adult, over anyone. I would pick him. He is the most resourceful 14-year-old boy that I know. He's like MacGyver. I call him my MacGyver. He can make something out of anything. He is so strong-willed.
I know that the two of them together are a dynamic team, and they are figuring this out.
Both are incredibly hopeful that their sons' experiences growing up around the water will carry them in the current, keeping their survival rate high. Yet the proximity of time expiring weighs heavy.
It's terrifying to know that your child is out there without you, and that if they need help, that you can't reach out your hand and give them the help that they need. That's what being a parent is. So not being able to do that is absolutely terrifying.
What started as a small community of support has turned into a national effort filled with prayers and optimism for Perry and Austin, a symbol of hope for these two women who cling to each other and wait. Now, the family put out a message tonight thanking everyone, the outpouring of support, all the prayers coming in from not just local people and local residents, but across the nation as well. They also announced that they have started a GoFundMe account to help raise money for the local efforts underway. A lot of people are searching for Perry and Austin with private vessels and with private aircraft. This GoFundMe account can be found at GoFundMe.com/Perry and Austin. We just checked a few minutes ago, and it's up to $37,000. It's only been opened for about 2 hours now. We all know social media has played a big role in this search and rescue effort and will continue over the next 24 to 48 hours. I want to welcome back in my colleague Kelly Dunn. She is standing by with more on the social media aspect and how it's proving to be a big impact and a big player in this. Kelly.
Exactly right, Jay. It's one of the easiest ways for people everywhere to stay up to date on the search for the boys and to offer support to the families. I'll draw your attention to a couple of pages on Facebook. This is a public page, and it's actually called #FindAustinAndPerry. You can see these people here just returned from Florida, prayers from Ohio. As you scroll down here, there's all kinds of, you know, prayers from Boston for Austin and Perry. All around the country, it just sees, you see these wonderful people that are out there praying, Cleveland, Ohio, Hope Sound, just really supporting the families. There's another one I'm going to call your attention to as well. This one was set up by a friend of the family, and that is Mr. Rob Thompson. And right now, I mean, we're up to over 50,000 members of this public group page. And earlier I was looking at it, and they had a lot of pictures of that service we just saw that was taking place. Oh, I don't see any of the pictures right now. But lots of information, not only on the search, but some of the pictures from the beautiful ceremony tonight when all those lanterns were lit up. Now, according to this post, and we were talking to Mr. Thompson today, he said you know, one of the best ways that people can help is to share posts from these pages and help people be on the lookout for maybe that white Yeti cooler and that engine cover that were not found with that capsized boat. Social media is also playing a possible role in the investigation, the ongoing search for these boys. Could the teens' final Snapchat messages be a crucial clue? News Channel 5's Brian Enton spoke with the boys' friends who say the final posts on social media were, to them, alarming.
I talked to him Thursday night. I was supposed to hang out with him Thursday afternoon, and then come Friday, he's missing.
Friends of 14-year-old Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen say Austin's final Snapchat Friday was concerning.
One of the other Snapchats I saw that he deleted right away said that, or didn't really say anything. It just showed the water. Then he pointed up behind him and a storm moved in real fast.
A storm moving in the photo, and soon after, the boys would be gone.
Made me a little bit nervous. And then I Snapchatted him, he didn't reply. So then that made me even more nervous.
Friends say Austin also Snapchatted about leaving Jupiter.
I saw Snapchat not referencing the Bahamas, but saying peace out, Jupe. And usually when we all say peace out, Jupe, we mean going to the Bahamas.
They joked before about boating to the Bahamas alone, but never actually did it. And their parents don't believe they would leave the area unless they got into trouble.
Nervous. I have confidence in them, though.
Confidence that keeps those young teens hopeful the final Snapchats weren't the last time they'll see their friends. Brian Enton, WPTV News Channel 5.
Coast Guard just tweeting out that they have completed 36 patterns and now covered more than 28,000 square nautical miles in their 72 hours of searching. Now, should they find Austin and Perry overnight, we will alert you with the WPTV mobile app. Now, tomorrow morning on Today on 5, live team coverage again from Palm Beach County north to Jacksonville. Today on 5 begins at 4:30 a.m.
Now, Storm Team 5 with South Florida's most accurate weather forecast.
Quiet night outside right now. Live 5 camera downtown West Palm Beach looking A-OK. Still a little bit of wet roads and puddles out there from the rain earlier. Temperatures, well, we're looking at 80 degrees at the moment. Cooled down earlier thanks to the rain. We're still at 81 for Boca, 80 in Boynton, 78 though for Vero and 79 for Pierce and Port St. Lucie and Okeechobee, 77. A couple of showers offshore. Those are not moving in our direction. 76 tonight, partly cloudy skies. Tomorrow we get more rain in the afternoon. We'll talk about that along with a look at the tropics coming up in a little bit.
New information tonight. The Coast Guard's also continuing to search tonight for a man last seen paddleboarding near Normandy Beach in St. Lucie County Friday. Coast Guard has identified the man as 58-year-old William Morlock. His sister reported him missing on Sunday. She hadn't heard from him since Friday. His car was still found in the parking lot at the beach. The Coast Guard spokesperson we spoke to says that they are using resources from all over the state to search for Morlock in addition to Austin and Perry.
A jury has found Scott Tobiasen guilty of dismembering his friend 2 years ago. Jurors began deliberating this morning and came back with their verdict just a few hours ago. They found Tobiasen guilty of first-degree murder. In 2013, Tobiasen accused of bludgeoning Gerald Longo to death before dismembering his body. Tobiasen was sentenced to life in prison. New at 11, the Boy Scouts of America end a blanket ban on gay adult leaders while allowing church-sponsored scout units to maintain the exclusion because of their faith. The Boy Scouts 80-member National Executive Board approved the policy change today during a teleconference. Now, the policy will try to ease a controversy that threatened the scouts with lawsuits. It goes into effect immediately.
An initial autopsy of Whitney Houston's daughter, Bobby Christina Brown, showed no obvious underlying cause of death and no significant injuries. That according to the Fulton County Medical Examiner's Office. Brown, who was 22, died on Sunday. She had been unconscious since being found unresponsive in the bathtub of her Roswell, Georgia home January 31st. Funeral services are set for Saturday morning in Alpharetta, Georgia, with a burial in New Jersey on Monday.
WPTV News Channel 5 back in just 60 seconds. A fight between neighbors going viral. Why smoke is at the center of that fight.
And Chrysler is getting slapped with a record-setting fine, the major hit to the bank account for putting your safety at risk.
Thanks, guys. Tom Cruise is here for a lip-sync battle of all battles. Plus, we have Dick Cavett. Music from Ashley Monroe and Buddy Guy sits in with the Roots. Do not change the channel. It's great.
the big one sale at Palm Beach Toyota. Big savings on the stylish Camry SE, $19,977, or only $167 a month. Big selection, 7 days a week. PalmBeachToyota.com.
Johnny, what happened?
Too many fireworks.
Well, get ready for even more bang for your buck.
More?
A Regal summer clearance event is going on now.
With more explosive savings?
Yep, with all savings clearly marked on over 3,500 new Dodge, Chrysler, Jeeps, and Rams. It's one easy, no hassle, no pressure buying experience.
Do our banks still want to say yes, you're approved?
Definitely. Now go get cleaned up.
I'm going to get some more fireworks.
Oh, no.
You got to go, a Regal.
West Palm, Fort Pierce, Sawgrass.
It's the big one sale at Palm Beach Toyota. Big savings on the new Corolla LE, $15,977, or only $137 a month. Big selection, 7 days a week. PalmBeachToyota.com.
New at 11, Governor Rick Scott made a stop in West Palm Beach today, visiting the young women at the PACE Center off Military Trail, which helps troubled teenage girls get an education. The governor announced today he's approving an additional $2 million to put toward the state's funding for the program. He says programs like the one at the PACE Center have helped the state's juvenile arrest rate drop to its lowest level in 30 years.
We want every child in our state to live the dream of this country. The dream of this country is get a great education and you can do anything you want. And that's what's going to happen in Florida.
The PACE Center for Girls will now receive a total of $18 million in funding to help teenagers get counseling and an education. The governor also approved additional funding for the Boys and Girls Clubs across the state. A neighbor versus neighbor feud is going viral. The dispute involves smoke coming from a backyard grill in St. Petersburg. A woman who lives across the street shot the video of the smoke from the grill that her neighbors, Chris Matt and his brother Dwayne, used to barbecue with. A county environmental specialist cited the brothers for generating too much smoke. The brothers say they're being harassed and they won't stop grilling.
Now to Decision 2016, a new controversy brewing on the campaign trail. GOP candidate Mike Huckabee under fire for his use of a Holocaust reference. Huckabee made a comment that suggests the president's nuclear deal with Iran is leading Israel, quote, into another Holocaust. The Anti-Defamation League says the comments are completely out of line and unacceptable. President Obama responded, saying in part, it would be considered ridiculous if it weren't so sad.
Fiat Chrysler ordered to pay a $105 million fine for mishandling recalls. The money is part of a settlement between Chrysler and the federal government over allegations of misconduct involving 23 recalls and 11 million vehicles. At least 75 people have died in crash-related fires. The recalls include defective steering parts, bad axles, electrical problems, and ignition switches. Fiat Chrysler says it accepts the consequences and promises to improve how it handles recalls.
The rising popularity of e-cigarettes has health experts concerned the devices may erase the progress made in reducing teen smoking. A new study found about one-fourth of high school juniors and seniors had tried e-cigarettes and almost 10% were current users. That's nearly double the number of teens who smoke traditional cigarettes. Many teens said they did not think that e-cigarettes posed a health risk.
Lobster mini season is this week, and the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission is allowing some divers to take home an extra lobster. Here's the deal, though. If you remove at least 10 lionfish, you then get to capture an extra lobster. Lionfish are an invasive species that can have a potentially negative impact on Florida's native wildlife and habitat. Lobster mini season is this Wednesday and Thursday.
Now, Storm Team 5 with South Florida's most accurate weather forecast.
Not bad weather either. Seas not going to be all that big, but of course, always dealing with thunderstorms out there. Live 5 camera, downtown West Palm Beach. All is quiet, 80 degrees right now with a south wind at 5 miles per hour. Not tracking any rain on land, just a few showers out over the Gulf Stream. 80 also in Boynton, 81 in Boca, 80 in Port St. Lucie. Oh, it dropped to 79 now, so upper 70s for the Treasure Coast and by the lake. Here's the hour-by-hour forecast. going into tomorrow morning. Temperatures down mid to upper 70s. A very nice morning, mostly dry. A lot of sunshine and southwest winds going to really heat things up quickly. We'll make it into the 90s very quickly, too. Then some isolated rain will start to pump up. Then that will turn into scattered showers and thunderstorms out there. That'll help us cool us off somewhat. And throughout the afternoon, we'll have scattered showers and thunderstorms out there going into the evening hours. Not raining the entire time, but from time to time, you get those waves move in from the west and those showers and storms fire on up. All right, in the tropics, we're watching area low pressure here in the Gulf. It's kind of drifting now up to the north. It's real, real weak. Not really expected to develop anymore. Have another low out here. That won't develop either. And in between, cloud cover and kind of a trough right over the state. That's what that's given us the better rain chances, too, with the low over here. We get that southwest flow pumping in over the area. Elsewhere in the tropics, check it out. The Caribbean just dry at the moment. A little upper level low here. Nothing to worry about. Most of the Atlantic just looking even cloud-free right now, so tropics will remain quiet for the next several days. And we see that low up there. A lot of cloud cover over the state starting to dissipate right now. Here's forecast on ViperCast. The morning, sunshine. The afternoon, storms come in. Again, generally moving from the west to the east, from the mainland to the offshore waters. And we'll start that mid-afternoon or so. May even get another round moving in about 5:30 or so. And then we will quiet down once again throughout the night and into Wednesday morning. Rain chances will remain somewhat high as we go in through the week, with scattered showers and thunderstorms expected at least each afternoon. Maybe you'll get one day and not the other day, but for the most part, still a lot of rain will be out there. Boating forecast, afternoon showers and storms. Again, be careful of those. Strong gusty winds as they exit the mainland and move to the offshore waters. Eyes to the west throughout the day. That way you can make it back to shore. Morning sunshine for the beachgoers. You'll get a lot of sun throughout the day, and then around 2 o'clock or so, you get those thunderstorms. 7-day forecast, mid-90s, real hot and humid with that southwest wind, and hanging on to somewhat the same weather pattern into the end of the week and even on into the weekend.
James, thank you. Americans love chocolate, but how much do we eat, and who are the world champs?
Plus, in sports, Emerson is the story of a Cardinal Newman grad training for an NFL rebirth.
When it's 5 o'clock on News Channel 5, you need to know what's happening right now. Steve Winkle with weather, safety, and accuracy right when and where you need it. WPTV News Channel 5.
How much are you spending on a complete pair of no-line bifocals? $250, $400, maybe even $550? Well, how about $99? Two-pair no-line bifocals for $99 plus free eye exam. Stanton Optical. Call 1-800-STANTON for nearest location.
It's here, the official Bremen Honda Summer Clearance Event. Now pick your payment on 11 acres of Hondas, the low payment that's right for you. Get this great summer clearance deal right now.
New Hondas from as low as $69 a month.
Mike Rodriguez has the best clearance savings right now. How do I know that? Because he's my dad. Your low Honda price out the door. That's the Bremen Honda bottom line.
Our customers say the most amazing things about the products and service they received from City Mattress. In fact, 99% of those surveyed said they'd recommend City Mattress to a friend. Not quite perfection, but we'll keep trying.
Congratulations, you're a winner!
This is the second best thing that's ever happened to me.
Wow. Congratulations, here's the deal.
This is the best thing that's ever happened to me! Yes!
It's the big one. Nothing beats a great deal on a new Toyota. Get a low 0% APR for 72 months on a new 2015 Toyota Prius. Toyota, let's go places.
It's that time of year when smart shoppers make their move. Schumacher's summer sell down. Get up to $11,000 off MSRP on the award-winning Chevy Silverado. Only at Schumacher.
Simply no match.
two pair of eyeglasses for $69, plus a free eye exam. Call 800-STANTON for nearest location.
It's official. Americans have a love affair with chocolate. I know I do. According to new numbers, we eat nearly 18% of the world's chocolate. That's about $18 billion worth. That's more than all of Asia Pacific combined. But that does not make us the world champs. No, it does not. That title goes to Switzerland, the motherland of chocolate giants such as Lindt and Toblerone.
Time now for the Honda Sports Desk with ESPN 106.3 on WPTV News Channel 5.
Well, in 5 days, every NFL team will be back on the field for good. Thank you. Training camps are here. Each franchise chasing the dream of reaching Super Bowl 50. But for Cardinal numer grad Jacoby Ford, what he's chasing is another NFL contract. Tonight, on his 28th birthday, the West Palm Beach native is grinding hard. This offseason, Ford's been working out with world-class trainer Tony Villani at XPE in Boca Raton, and it's paying off because the former Oakland wide receiver with track star speed was just invited to Tennessee's training camp, and after spending all of last season out of the NFL, Ford's ready to make the most of his shot with the Titans.
You know, it's not easy to stay in this league. You know, once you get there, you know, you have to do a lot of little things to stay, and that's something that, you know, I think I took for granted a little bit at first, but, you know, it just kind of humbled me and put me back into, you know, perspective of, like, you know, you got to go back and just start doing everything right.
Ford and the rest of Tennessee reporting for training camp on Friday. FAU football playing host to a specialist camp on Monday. Kickers, punters, long snappers perfecting their craft, taking lessons from renowned teacher Jamie Cole. He's helped guys like Dolphins kicker Caleb Sturgis make an NFL roster. It's a lonely, pressure-packed position that Coach Charlie Partridge says deserves a lot more credit.
It's critical. I mean, from field position on kickoff to obviously scoring points on extra points and field goals, it's critical. And you know, in today's day and age, there's an expectation for them to make it, let's be honest. And unfortunately for them, a lot of times they get more press when they don't make it as opposed to when they do, unless it's a certain situation. So they need to be able to perform with that in mind.
Owls open up fall camp 1 week from tonight. Marlins second baseman and leadoff hitter D. Gordon continues to work his way back from a dislocated thumb. If all goes well in his rehab start tonight, he could be cleared to join Miami as soon as tomorrow. The 27-year-old speedster doing work with the Jupiter Hammerheads at Roger Dean Stadium. Only 1-for-4 on the night. His only hit coming in the third. Throwing error. Gordon landing at third, but Big Blue says you gotta head back to second. But the highlight of the night coming before the game when DG buys the entire team Cuban food for dinner.
I got it for them the night in the second game, so hopefully they enjoy it.
Well, it's pretty good right here, so you know, clubhouse guy recommended it.
Yeah, his teammates loving him tonight. I can guarantee that. Anytime you guys would like to buy dinner at the newsroom,
that's right.
I'm cool with that too.
Roast capollo, some black beans and rice, something like that.
Bring it on, baby. Let's eat.
You go raising for any leftover on anybody's desk.
That is pretty much
you'd eat anything that was put in front of you.
Be true. That might be true. It is true.
It is.
We'll be right back.
Listen to ESPN 106.3 FM. Mike and Mike start your morning, and Evan Cohen on the ride home.
Weather on WPTV is sponsored by El Dorado Furniture.
Headhorse is gonna save you.
Big selection means big savings. It's the Big One sales event this month at Headhorse Delray Toyota. Save big with zero down on new Camrys. Lease for $189 a month or buy for $18,988. Visit DelrayToyota.com.
Nice.
Chevy's got three great deals to choose from this summer. Which works the best with your budget?
I'm drawn to the 0%.
$1,000 cash back.
I've never ever thought about leasing a car until I saw that deal.
Now let me tell you something that's super cool. You can choose any one of these deals on any of these cars.
Seriously?
Current qualified GM lessees can get this Chevy Cruze LT for around $169 a month. And get $500 lease bonus cash on select Cruze vehicles in stock. See your South Florida Chevy dealer.
In case of an emergency, I can always use my Lifeline cell phone to call for help.
SafeLink, the free phone program, free cell, free text, and free minutes, is your connection to safety. If you qualify for programs such as SNAP or Medicaid, today you are eligible for 500 free minutes for the first 4 months and unlimited free texts.
With SafeLink, my family can feel secure when I am alone.
Call 1-800-SAFELINK or visit safelink.com.
your South Florida BMW centers today for exceptional offers.
Every day, you're breathing 20,000 breaths. Do you know what you're breathing in? Your indoor air can be 2 to 5 times worse than outdoor air. Filtrete Healthy Living Filters can help improve your indoor air quality with exclusive Filtrete brand 3-in-1 technology from 3M to pull in and trap unwanted particles, letting cleaner air flow through. Every breath is a reason to care about your air. So make every breath count with Filtrete Filters.
Oh, is Mr. Bear joining us for dinner?
Yeah, bears like salmon too.
Well, this is very special salmon, Mr. Bear. It's only around for a little while.
Sounds good.
Would you like a whole piece so you can share with Mr. Bear?
Yes, please. So, Mr. Bear? Mommy, Mr. Bear says he likes ice cream too.
But Mr. Bear has to finish his salmon first.
Okay.
Publix Fresh Wild Alaskan Sockeye Salmon is never frozen, but it won't be around long, so enjoy it while it's here. Only at Publix, where shopping is a pleasure.
Selection means big savings. It's the Big One sales event this month at Edmore's Delray Toyota. Save big with zero down on new Camrys. Lease for $189 a month or buy for $18,988. Visit DelrayToyota.com.
Final look at the forecast. Tomorrow, a hot day, highs in the middle 90s, afternoon showers and thunderstorms. We'll see that through the weekend. Picking up more of an east flow over on the weekend, though, so that may taper down the shower chance a little bit.
All right, more on your weather, your traffic, and of course the overnight developments involving those missing young boaters out of Tequesta. All that starting at 4:30 tomorrow morning.
We're always breaking news on WPTV.com. Have a great night.
Good night.
Attention, South Florida homeowners. Pending legislation will slash air conditioner utility rebates by up to 60%. So turn to the experts at Lindstrom and get a new Carrier air conditioning system with up to $19.80 in utility and consumer rebate.
Yeah. I love those guys.
Johnny, you're a mess.
The 4th of July sale was a blast.
3,500 new Dodge, Chrysler, Jeeps, and Rams gotta go during the summer clearance event. So go get cleaned up.
Get no hassle buying, and our banks just want to say, yes, you're approved.
You gotta go, Arrigo.
Sayuri 516 posted.
Off to buy stuff for the home, stuff for the kids, even stuff for the dog. Hashtag bigger Honda, please.
Wow, looks like it's time to switch your Accord for a CR-V. Oh, I mean an Odyssey. Come to the Honda Summer Clearance Event. The Odyssey is the best-selling minivan in its class with plenty of room for all of them.
I love it.
Actually, there's room for more.
Hurry in to the Honda Summer Clearance Event for a great deal on your new Honda.
Looks like the Garcia's got a new car.
What'd they get?
I don't know.
Sure doesn't look like a Buick.
Buick.
I'm outside. Where are you?
I'm right here. I'm in the Buick.
I don't see a Buick.
Take a fresh look at Buick. It just might surprise you.
That's not a Buick.
That's what I told him.
Wow. This is nice. Oh, my.
Now current lessees. Switch to Buick and lease this 2015 Enclave for around $298 a month.
It's amazing what you can do with a click these days. Just click to make any night family movie night. Just click to order your favorite dinner. And now, just click to save up to $250 a year on your energy bill. With FPL's online home energy survey, it's now easier to fast forward to personalized savings. Go to fpl.com/easy-to-save to take the survey and make your bill even lower.
It's a golden opportunity to discover the exhilaration of efficiency. With 6 models to choose from, there's a Lexus hybrid for every driver. Come into the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event, where you'll find some of the best offers of the year on our entire hybrid lineup. Lease the 2015 CT200H for $299 a month for 36 months, and we'll make your first month's payment. See your Lexus dealer.
You're right. Time for new tires. With your appointment, we'll install them in less than 59 minutes, or you get $59 back and a free oil change.
Sounds good.
The 59-minute quick tire install. Guaranteed every day with an appointment. You can even time us. That's another plus from Tires Plus.
The perfect car calls for the perfect price, and Lexus of Palm Beach has it. During the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event, lease a new 2015 Lexus IS 250, $200 a month with complimentary first month's payment, or a new ES 350, $300 a month with complimentary first month's payment. Don't miss the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Hurry to Lexus of Palm Beach. Price perfection. LexusofPalmBeach.com.
Attention homeowners, save up to $1,980 on a new Carrier air conditioning system when you turn to the experts at Lindstrom Air Conditioning and Plumbing. Pending Florida legislation will slash air conditioner utility rebates by up to 60%.
Yeah, I love those guys.
Closed captioning on WPTV is sponsored by Bethesda Health.
Yeah.